And what about any metrics or things that you measured which you thought were important that weren't?
So I don't know if this exactly is what you're looking for, but I can definitely think of situations where metrics told us a story that didn't really match reality. And one of these situations, we went through a period of time where our growth was really, really fast. We were acquiring new MRR, monthly recurring revenue, very, very quickly. And we would put that number up on the board every month, and everybody was cheering. And one of the things we started noticing that while our new MRR growth was going up and up and up, our churn numbers were also growing up. So we had customers that were falling out of the back of the pipeline as well. And for anybody who's been involved in a SaaS business, your churn is one of the most important metrics to track, because it means that when it's high, you've got a leaky bucket. And you need to work harder and harder to fill that bucket while water pours out of it. And when we dug into it, it turns out that we had been giving our customers, we've been giving new customers a short amount of time where they could do a trial with us, and then forcing them to make a big decision after that amount of time was up. And for a lot of these bigger companies that we'd never really worked with before, this just wasn't enough time. And so they would start a trial, they would get to the end of this trial, and they wouldn't be ready to actually commit or not, and they would fall out, they would churn out. And so while we were able to, because of these short trials, we're able to sort of say, hey, there's no commitment up front, we're able to get a lot of new revenue in through the door, we also were creating a situation where ultimately we didn't provide a good customer experience. And so that was a situation where, you know, we had a metric which looked really great, but there was something underneath that we hadn't seen that was pretty important to pay attention to.